Okay, this video I'm going to show you how to do parts per million, also known as PPMs. Parts per million, that's grams of solute divided by grams of solution times 1 million. A solution is the solute, which is the stuff being dissolved, and the solvent, which is usually water. So the first problem we're going to do is we're going to solve for parts per million. So what's the concentration of the solution in parts per million if we have 0.02 grams of NaCl, so that's grams of solute, 0.02 grams, dissolved in 1,000 grams of solution. So we just times that by a million, and we'll solve for our answer. Now I'm just going to show you a quick trick. 1, 2, 3 zeros, they're going to knock out 3 zeros. So it's really just 0.02 times 1,000, and you get 20, and the units are parts per million. Okay. The next problem we're going to solve for mass of solute. What's the total mass of solute? So we have x grams over 1,000 grams of solution times 1 million is equal to 5 ppm. So, again, we knock out the three zeros, 1, 2, 3, and we're going to take the 1,000 and divide 5 ppm is by 1,000, 5 divided by 1,000 equals 0.05 grams. And that's your mass of solute. And the last one I'm going to go over is a June 2007 parts per million question that was really nasty, because it was a two-point question, 1 point for the setup and 1 point for the answer. Most students got the answer part, but the setup was just really nasty, because, we'll just go through it. An aqueous solution has 0.007 grams of oxygen. 0.0070 grams of oxygen. Dissolved in 1,000 grams of water. 1,000 grams of water. So times a million is equal to your parts per million. However, I have to go back up to the equation. It said grams of solution, right there, grams of solution. Water is not the solution. Water and oxygen is the solution. You're supposed to add the 0.007 grams. It does nothing to the equation, but the setup had to be there. Yet the question was, what's the definition of a solution? So that part right there, that divided by 1,000.007, and we times that by a million, and look, 6.99, well, that comes out to 7.0 parts per million. It didn't have an effect on the parts per million calculation, but it did screw a lot of students up in New York State on that question. So that's how you do parts per million.